Hello, and welcome to Tom Paxton, Still Ramblin'. This is a new series for Radio 2, and in the course of the next 8 weeks, I'll be hooking up with some friends old and new. Look out for Iris Dement, John Prine, Peter Paul and Mary, Hal Ketchum, Janice Ian, Guy Clark, and Kathy Mattea. Tonight, however, my guest truly deserves the title Living Legend. It is Pete Seeger, who over 50 years ago was a founding member of the quintessential American folk group, The Weaver. How many folk groups can boast big band arrangements? Classic Weavers, there. Waymaway, one of their biggest hits. He's been described as America's tuning fork and Johnny Appleseed Jr., and it's not surprising when you look at the list of people who have sung his songs. Aretha Franklin, Bonnie Raitt, Jackson Brown, Marlena Dietrich, and Bruce Springsteen are simply a handful who have sung songs like Kisses Sweeter Than Wine, If I Had a Hammer, Where Have All the Flowers Gone, and We Shall Overcome.
We shall overcome. We shall overcome. We shall overcome someday. Darling, hear my heart. Yeah.
Bruce Springsteen there from a recent double album of cover versions of Pete Seeger's songs. Now, time to hear the man himself. Approaching 80, Pete's voice is not perhaps all that it used to be, but the passion, spirit, and moral authority which underlies everything he does is still very much in evidence. When we got together in New York last January, he started us off with one of his new songs, A Little Bit of This and That.
My grandma, she can make a soup with a little of this and that. She can feed the whole sloop group with a little of this and that. Stone soup, you know the story. Stone soup, who needs the glory? But with grandma's cooking, no need to worry. Just a little of this and that. Grandma likes to make a garden grow with a little of this and that. But she likes to have the ground just so with a little of this and that. Not too loose, not too firm. In the spring, it's all gotta be turned. In the fall, lots of compost to feed the worms with a little of this and that. Grandma knows we can build a future with a little of this and that.
You got it.
And a few arguments never, never hurt you with a little this and that. True, this world's in a hell of a fix. Some say oil and water don't mix. But they don't know a salad maker's tricks with a little this and that. The world to come may be like a song with a little this and that. To get everybody to sing along with a little this and that. A little dissonance ain't no sin. A little skylarking to give us all a grin. Who knows, but God's got a plan for the people to win with a little this and that.
How did you come to write that song?
So a newspaper headline in New York, a black woman in Harlem ran a soup kitchen, mm-hmm. and the reporter says, where do you get the funding? Oh, she says, funding is tight. It's harder and harder every year. But somehow we do it with a little of this and that.
Oh, that's great. Yeah. Well, Pete, here we sit in the middle of Midtown Manhattan, a few blocks from Carnegie Hall, which is the first place where I saw you perform.
Oh,
I was
no.
just out of the Army in 1960, and one of the first things I did with my newfound freedom was get up to Carnegie Hall on a Friday night for one of the sing-out hootenannies that you were...
Good God.
Doing a series of hootenannies to raise money for Sing Out magazine. I saw your program there in 1960. The one that I would love to have seen, although I was still a student in Oklahoma, was the one that you and the Weavers gave there Christmas Eve of 1954. And the recording that was made of that, the Weavers at Carnegie Hall...
I think it was 55.
55.
Yeah.
Well, that, for me, was an epiphany. I came by a friend's house one day, and he said, listen to this, and he put the needle on this album, and out came your banjo introduction to Darlin' Corey. And I like to tell people that by the time I heard both sides of that LP, I had undergone a chromosomal change. I had absolutely turned from someone who loved folk music into someone who simply had to do it or bust. It was people's music in the very, very finest sense of the word. Tell me a little bit about that, what everyone considers to be a historical concert.
The Weavers had hit records in 1950 and 51, and then the Blacklisters caught up with us, and we decided to take a sabbatical.
What was this Blacklist like?
Well, it just meant you didn't get commercial jobs. You could sing for your friends, but you didn't get jobs on radio or television.
And this was because of your politics.
That's right. Or what they thought were our politics.
Mm-hmm.
And as Lee says, we took a sabbatical and it turned into a Mundical and a Tuesdical. But we had a friend named Harold Leventhal. He's my age, who had once been a song plugger for Irving Berlin. But now he was working for his brother, who had a textile company of some sort. But he really wanted to get back into music. And he said to us, I think you could have a reunion concert. He went to Town Hall. They said, oh, no, we can't rent to radical people like the Weavers. He went to Carnegie Hall. They said, oh, if you have the money, we'll rent to you. And so somehow he found the thousands of dollars. And to everybody's surprise, including ours, that darn concert was a sellout. So all of a sudden, the Weavers are back in business. Only trouble is, being a member of a quartet, as you probably know, is like being a member of a family. And I had a growing family of my own at the time. Our third child was born that year. And so in 57, I bowed out of the Weavers.
What's that wonderful song of yours? Give us a little bit of the song about sailing up my golden river.
You know where I swipe the tune, don't you?
Where? That's inspired theft.
Sunlight glancing on the water. Life and death are all my own. Yet I was never alone. Life to raise my sons and daughters, golden sparkles in the foam. And I was not far from home, say. Sailing down this winding highway, travelers from near and far. Yet I was never alone. Exploring all the little byways, sighting all the distant stars. And I was not far from home. Missed the note.
I love that song.
I would love some woman with a good voice like Enya to sing that. We don't know Enya's records much over in this country, but I understand her record of How Can I Keep From Singing sold 6 million copies in Europe.
Wow.
You know, I started that song off. I didn't start it off. I'm sorry. I started off its modern career.
Mm-hmm.
A friend of my wife's mother was a woman from North Carolina. And in 1950, she says, "Peter, this was my grandmother's favorite song. It was made up way back in the 1850s. And to be against slavery in North Carolina in the 1850s was not an easy thing to be." And she said to me, she said, "Honey, don't ever forget this song." And my friend, her name was Doris Plenn, didn't tell me that she had added a new third verse to it. Mm-hmm. These were the days when Senator Joe McCarthy was starting ranting and raving, and Doris had written a beautiful third verse, "When tyrants tremble sick with fear and hear their death knells ringing, when friends rejoice both far and near." I think Doris's grandmother was a Quaker.
Uh-huh.
"How can I keep from singing in prison cell and dungeon vile, our thoughts to them are winging, when friends by shame are undefiled. How can I keep from singing?" Great song.
What was the first song you ever learned to play on the banjo?
Oh, me, I think old Joe Clark, and I didn't play it very well. It's a great banjo tune, though.
How many banjo players are out there today who made their first foray onto the instrument from your little Folkways 10-inch record, How to Play the Five-String Banjo?
Or my little 72-page book, How to Play the Banjo. Well, this banjo, I guess this is typical of American life in many ways. Something gets brought over from the other part of the world, and it gets changed here. The first banjos that came here were played by slaves who were not allowed to play drums. Oh, dangerous. They might start slave revolts. But they were allowed to play this simple instrument. And here it was picked up by white people around the 1830s and 40s. Of course, they had to put black on their face and try and talk with exaggerated dialect accent.
Mm-hmm.
They called it the minstrel show. But the banjo swept American music just like rock and roll did 100 years later. And then it died out as popular music changed. But way back in the hills where people didn't keep up the time, they still played banjo. And they'd play a fast rhythm and sing a long, long, slow song. So they made up a very interesting combination of singing a long, slow melody with a very rapid boom, 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 boom.
Yeah, I mean, Burl Ives does that as well. Well, you're playing something fast underneath and singing in a long line. I do a song, for example. Every time I hear sweet birds singing, I think of you and I, my dear. I think of you and I. When I hear the evening bells a-ringing, I hang my head and I cry, my dear. Hang my head and cry. And they will ring when we are gone. so that the instrument kind of provides a carpet, or...
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, carpet is a good description, the Persian carpet with all those little flowers in it.
Yeah, but I hear that a lot in Appalachian folk songs.
When did you write that last song?
Oh, very, very early, about 1961, something like that.
It's a beautiful song.
Thank you. Okay, this is BBC Radio 2, 88 to 91 FM, and I'm Tom Paxton. My guest tonight is Pete Seeger. Pete, do me a favor. Sing with me, however you want to, a little bit of Where Have All the Flowers Gone?
Oh.
I'll carry as much of the burden as you like, but I just want the honor of doing it with you. What key do you do it in?
I'll do it in A.
In A.
Way down there, in a growly key. Where have all the flowers gone?
Sing it. Long time passing.
Sing it again.
Where have all the flowers gone? Long time ago. Where have all the flowers gone?
Girls have picked them.
Girls have picked them, everyone. When will they ever learn? Oh, when will they ever learn?
Where have all the young girls gone?
Where have all the young girls gone? Long time passing. Where have all the young girls gone? Long time ago. Where have all the young girls
taken husbands?
Taken husbands, everyone. When will they ever learn? When will they ever learn?
Where have all the young men gone?
Where have all the young men gone?
Long time.
Long time passing. Where have all the young men gone?
Long time.
Long time ago.
Where?
Where have all the young men gone?
They're all in uniform.
They're all in uniform, everyone.
When will we?
When will we ever learn? When will we ever learn? Thank you for that, Pete.
I made it up in a plane in about 20 minutes, those three verses, and stuck the paper on a microphone and sang it at Oberlin College.
Mm-hmm.
And somehow Peter, Paul, and Mary heard it, and they started singing it. Kingston Trio got it from them, and my manager, Harold Leventhal, said, Pete, didn't you write a song called Where Have All the Flowers Gone? I said, yeah, 2, 3, 4 years ago. He said, did you ever copyright it? I said, no, I guess I didn't. I did record it for Folkways, but that's all. He said, well, you ought to copyright it. The Kingston Trio over just recorded it. So I got on the phone to Dave Gard. He said, oh, Pete, we didn't know it was your song. We'll take our name off it. It was very nice of him because legally I had, as lawyers say, abandoned copyright.
On the other hand, the Byrds did a recording of your song Turn, 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 which the credits, I think, are Ecclesiastes Seeger.
Now, that means teacher in Greek. And I'm told that the original name of Ecclesiastes was Koheleth, which means teacher in Hebrew. This was not a really ancient piece of poetry. The book of Ecclesiastes was probably written about 300 years before the time of Jesus, when the Greek armies had swept through that part of the world, and a lot of Greek ideas had been given to the various peoples. And I'm told you can tell by the style of poetry it is that whoever Koheleth was, he was influenced by Greek.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I happened to come along the lines in leafing through the Bible once, and I jot them down and stick them in my pocket. And I got a letter from my publisher saying, Pete, can't you write another song like Goodnight, Irene? these protest songs you keep writing, I can't market them. And I was angry. I sat down with a tape recorder and says, get yourself another songwriter. This is the only kind of song I know how to write. And I pulled out this piece of paper and improvised a tune and taped it and sent it to him. Got a nice letter. Thanks, just what I was looking for. And he was the one who got it to the Birds.
So do a little of it for us.
Well, let me borrow
you. Borrow the guitar. Sure.
Now you help me sing it. To everything.
To everything. Turn, turn, turn. There is a season. Turn, turn, turn.
And a
time for every purpose under
a time
heaven.
To be born, a time to die.
A time to be born, a time to
plant,
die.
To reap.
A time to plant, a time to reap.
To kill, to heal.
A time to kill, a time to heal.
To laugh, to weep.
A time to laugh,
a time
to weep.
Anybody listening, you sing it too.
To everything. Turn, turn, turn. There is a season. Turn, turn, turn. And a time for every purpose under heaven.
Time to build up, a time to break down.
A time to build up, a time to break
to dance,
down.
To mourn,
a time to dance. A time to
cast away stones.
A time to cast away stones.
To gather stones.
A time to gather stones together.
Here we go, all of us.
Do everything. Turn, turn, turn. There is a season. Turn, turn, turn. And a time. For every purpose under heaven.
Now let me see if I can remember all the verses, because my memory is going. Oh, here's the last verse for Henry. Time to gain, a time to lose.
A time to gain, a time to lose.
A time to rend, a time to sow.
A time to rend, a time to sow.
Time of love, a time of hate.
A time of love, a time to
hate. Time of peace,
a time of peace.
I swear it's not too late. One more time.
To everything, turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, turn. And a time for every purpose under heaven.
What a song. You just improvise that melody.
Yeah.
So that means that you basically had written all of the verses.
All I did was add the turn, 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 and the very last line, a time of peace, I swear it's not too late.
Mm.
Because the original simply said, a time of war, a time of peace. And now we're 6 billion people, and there's not that much more room in the earth for many more billions. And we're going to have to learn to live with each other in spite of, wow, what differences.
And you know, you've just reminded me of an old song of mine that in the key of G that you might help me do.
Peace. Peace will come, and let it begin with me. We need peace, and let it begin with me. Oh, my own life is all I can hope to control. Oh, let my life be lived for the good of my soul. Let it bring peace, sweet peace. Peace will come. Let it begin with me. Now
I'll do for you what you did with me. I'll line it out for you. It's peace.
Peace.
Peace will.
Peace will.
Peace will come.
Peace will come. Let it begin with me.
We need.
We need.
We need peace.
We need peace.
Let it begin with me. Then it's all my own life. It's all I can hold to control. Oh, let my life be lived for the good, good of my soul. Let it bring peace,
sweet peace.
Sweet peace.
Peace will come. Peace will come. Let it begin with me. With me.
That sounded good. Thank you.
Wow, how lovely.
Pete, thanks so much for coming by. It's been great being with you.
Well, thank you for asking me down. We're sitting high up in the air in one of these New York skyscrapers. But Lord, I guess the sounds go all around.
They do indeed. Thanks a lot, Pete.
I hope you enjoyed that as much as Pete and I did. Tom Paxton Still Ramblin' was produced by Donald McInnes with Colin Stephen on the sound. Next week, my guest will be the wonderful new country singer with the old-time feel, Iris DeMent.
Everybody is wondering what and where they all came from. Everybody is worried about where they're gonna go when the whole thing's done. But no one knows for certain, and so it's all the same to me. I think I'll just let the mystery be.
Goodbye.